们的意思，他的意思。青花菜呀、So, may I first identify where you from? Yeah, using all department. English major. English major and what grade? Sophomore. Senior class. Okay, and how about you?
Libra,
okay, so
we are the same.
So you are from the Department of English. Oh, yeah, welcome. Okay, I just transferred from National Science and University to this college. And this course is sponsored by the Ministry of Education. It's a part of the Ministry of Education, 教育. They want to improve the quality of general education through some sponsorship. So last semester, they asked me to develop a course to introduce some Taiwan's culture, education, especially some customs to foreign students. But in my opinion, even Taiwanese are not do not realize our own symbol, our own culture exactly. So yeah. So last semester, with my experience, improved my thinking that many. Last semester, there were 16 students who took the course in Sanders University. But that was a graduate level course. And 16 students took the course. 80 students from abroad, 4 from Singapore, 1 from Turkey, and 2 from France, and one from Korea, South Korea, and the rest 8 are from Taiwan. And the Taiwanese students, they admit that some of the topics that we discussed, they never think of that. And when I took them to visit Taoist temple and even the Buddhist temple, and I asked the Taoist priest to introduce some ritual to them. For example, how to throw the divine block, the divine block, what way, how to call them, and the rule, the regulations. How to get the permission from the god or the goddess? The very strict regulation and very very difficult to get the final permission from the god or goddess. So I found out that even Taiwanese did not realize that exactly. So I think that this course is not only for foreigners, even for the youngsters. Also work for them. So this master, when I transferred here, I said, okay, I can welcome. So are you interested in the course of Taiwan's educational system and culture? Okay, welcome. You can see. Okay, so this semester is my second time to teach this course, and I make some revisions. I had a bridge at the content of this course. So I focus on six topics. The first of all is education systems, and the second one is the religions. The third one is ethnic group and languages. And then the world customs and maybe we can look at the course description. So this is a 2-hour creating our course. Okay. So Qinghua Tai is my name. My professor teacher education center, but now I met as the chairperson of the DRI. And this is my email address. And this is the office hour. Okay, so let's take a look at the content. The six main themes: Taiwan's educational administration system. Second one is Taiwan's school systems. That's you already underwent the systems. And then the third one is Taiwan's current educational, educational issues. And then the Taiwan's religions, Taiwan's core custom and rituals. And then the last one is ethnic groups and languages in Taiwan. Okay. So the course objective is to better understand Taiwan's educational systems, its current status, and future development. So we will describe the current educational systems. Educational systems means the educational administration systems and school systems. And then the current issues, some controversial issues. For example, the 12-year basic education.
English or even in some other language. Maybe you know French.
19th centuries, when the nationalism are very popular at that time. So Germany or Dutch is the first country in the world to have compulsory education. You know what is compulsory education? That means that you have to go to school. If you are not going to school when you are age 6 or age 5 or age 7, you will be punished. But you are only a child. You are not a citizen. You are not old enough. So your parents, welcome, citizen. If you are not going to schools when you reach a certain age, and you will be punished. So that's an obligation. You have obligations. You have obligations to go to school. That's a compulsory. So that's a thinking of nationalism, because if you are the people of my country and you are obliged to go to school to earn some knowledge, and then you are entitled to enjoy the privilege of this country. So that's a thinking of the nationalism. But now, not anymore. So that's why the Hong Kong people are afraid of their government wanting to implement the women's job, because they afraid that their government wants to brainstorm their younger generations. They think that we are Hong Kong, the society of Hong Kong is a democratic society. If you want to promote the patriotic values, and you should make the government, make the systems be proud, not brainstorming the values, the thinkings into the brain of the younger generations. So this, the 12th year, now our government tried to implement the 12th year. Actually I like to translate these terms into basic education. That's a so-called basic education. So our government announced that this 12-year national or basic education will be implemented starting from the year of 2014. So 2 years later, the 12-year basic education is not a compulsory education. I have said that. If it is a compulsory education, and so you have to receive the 12 years free education, or you will be punished. Your parents will be punished. But actually, now in Taiwan, we have 9-year compulsory education from the age 6 to age 15, right? 15. That's a nine-year compulsory education. Now, starting from 2014, longer, 3 years longer than now. That means that after age 15 years old, and you can choose to accept the 3 more years in high school, in vocational high school, or in the junior college, Zhuangke. And then you got free education. But if you choose not, you won't be punished. Your parents won't be punished. So actually, it's not compulsory. It's only a, we can call it a basic education, not a compulsory education. Okay. They decide to go to school. And what kind of school?
Any elementary school and junior.
Are you?
But we don't want to join that system.
Oh. Oh yes. Yes. In Taiwan, we have that system. We call that home schooling. We call that home schooling. In the translation is we have that kind of systems, and this practice is very popular in United States because the parents do not believe what the normal schools are teaching. For example, a group called Amish. My neighbor in there. I studied in Buffalo, New York, and very close to the state of Pennsylvania. And in Pennsylvania, especially there's a town called Lancaster. Lancaster is the cluster of Amish. I heard that Amish people emigrate from northern part of Germany, and now they still resist to use the electricity. They don't want to use the electricity even now, and so they don't want to send their kids to schools. They keep their kids within their household. Yes, around us. And when you get out of the house, you need to put a hat. And when a man get married, they never shave. So usually they have long beard. But they are not allowed to been taking pictures. So have you seen a movie called Witness? Witness. Very, very famous movie. I suggest you to watch that movie. Star by Harrison Ford. In Namasha. they are reluctant to send their kids to schools. So several years ago, their parents must receive the fines, must be punished by the government because they didn't send their kids to schools. But now it's okay because we have a homeschooling system. They send a plan to the Education Bureau, to Jiaoyuji, and then we review their plans. That we make sure that the parents have the ability and the knowledge to teach their kids. Or they can send for some experts. For example, you are a family, and my family, two families can afford to send for an expert to teach these two families' kids. And that's okay. If their plans show us that, okay, and then we give them the permissions. So every year in Kaohsiung cities, there are more than 60, I think about 60 to 80 kids are receiving the homeschooling. So that's okay. Oh yeah, you have to go to school to take the midterm examinations and the final examination, because next year want the graduation certificate. For the junior high education, they decide that they want to go to the traditional schools, and they must have some proof that they already finished their elementary school. So they have to, or nobody knows that whether they have learned or not. Okay. Now, yeah, you can look on the front page of Ministry of Education. Yeah, there are lots of debate, lots of discussion, lots of propaganda on the 12-year basic education. Okay. Okay, let's continue. So we will spend our first three weeks, right? Beijing, Qianshan Zhou, the first 3 weeks we discuss about the education. And then, first today, and then 3 weeks. 3 weeks we will discuss about our education and school systems. And then, go back to the course description. Okay, and then the second one is to better understand Taiwan's core customs, ethnic group and languages. And about the core customs, and we will discuss about the religion. First of all, we will talk about religions. In my opinion, I think religion is usually the basic standpoint of each society. In Western society, we go to churches. Yeah, in Taiwan, we go to the Taoist temple or Buddhist temple. And I think in every country, I think the religion is usually the basic infrastructures of their culture and their society. So I focus on the religions very much. So in our course, we will discuss the four religions. The first, because here in Taiwan, I think the most popular religion is Taoism. It's Taoism. So I have invited a Taoist priest, Sai Gong. There will be a Sai Gong coming to our classrooms and wearing his robe. 他的道士袍. So I'm thinking, well, he can change, not in the lab, maybe in my office, or if he wearing his robe and walking from our front gate and the wall. That would be very funny. That would be very funny. So maybe to my third floor, deep line office, change. You know, it's very difficult to be a Taoist priest. You know that this procedure, the procedure. Oh, you have to learn the song, and you have to learn the classic of Taoist classic, and pass the test. And the final test is you have to climb up the how many steps? Tao Ti. With naked feet, and step on the 49, 49, 49 gilt, down, shout, and 那个赤脚, and climb up to the top, and then you pass the test. Yeah. So this the priest is a part-time priest. Part-time priest. Actually, he's a public servant. He's a public servant in the Kaohsiung government sports department. 在体育处，一个股长。I used to be the superintendent of Kaohsiung city government. 我原来是 高雄市政府的教育局局长，所以他们是 my colleague. So I asked. Please to come. Okay, so the Taoist, Buddhist, Catholic, and Christian, four religions, actually Confucius, 儒教. Many foreigners consider Confucius doctrines. Is also a religion, but we don't think. Yeah, we never think that the Confucius temple is a temple, right? We never think about. Many foreigners ask me that you are Confucius. That means that my belief is Confucius. I said, oh no, that's not a religion in our thinking. Okay, so customs, religions. And then all customs, our daily life in the lunar calendars, we have a new year, right? And then now this month is very special. It's very special. You know that. Anyone from Taiwan? You are all from Taiwan, right? You are from where are you from? Sorry. So this is a money. This is a paper money. Sometimes we call the ghost money. Then this is the new form of ghost money. The traditional ghost money. The traditional concept of Chinese or Taiwanese, we divide the world into three parts, three layers. Now we are in the middle one. So if you behave good enough after your death, then you go to the heaven, right? If you not behave badly, then you go to the hell. And this money, we call the ghost money. So every time we worship to our ancestors or we went to the Taoist temples, after the worship, we burn this money as a kind of a deity to the god, to the goddess, or to our ancestors for their use in the heaven, in the other world, in the other world. So now, they use that, 1,080 dollars, and even they have a check
有钱，一个是钱，对呀，一个是你，就是你对呀。
So now, people seldom use the gold, yellow one.
They still use that. They still use that, but they use that, they have to burn a lot of paper. So it's a kind of a concern, environmental protection.
Maybe 1 yellow paper means $1. But is it
I don't know. I don't know. But whatever. So in Japan, we never burn money, right? In Japan, we never burn money. And you give the, some money into the lot, right? Into the lot. Okay. So, and then ethnic groups. How many and the regional groups in Taiwan? So far, how many? In Japan, Nihongo, Kahosan, in Nihongo, you know.
So we have midterm examinations.
That's an overlook. That's a short presentation. What you have observed in Taoist temple or in schools, maybe we can arrange a tour to the nearby schools, elementary schools, and you can have classroom observations, and then talk about and write a short paper about 1,000 words, about 1,000 words for your most report, this is final report. IEPO report. Okay. Yes. Okay. Now we're done. Okay. The requirements and the policy, evaluation policies, very clear. Okay. And textbooks. Textbooks only one. One textbook. And sorry, I forgot to bring the textbooks. I left them at home. I read it yet last night. But bring with me for the Taiwan from the eyes of a foreigner. And the second one is the statistics. And you can look on the Ministry of Education's homepage, and then you can search some information about Taiwan's schools, some figures.
Okay, so the cycle.
最多的是这一天了。哪一天？
第
三。
嗯。
啊，第二，the first one。The first one。Yeah. So October 17th, we will invite the Taoist priest to come in with us to hear us experience why he wants to be a Taoist priest and talk about something very strange and interesting to us. Okay.In the midterm, I just said that 1,000 words, okay?
They have one class called the bilingual class.
but it's difficult to get here by bus. Okay. So any questions or any suggestions to this course?